people with an agenda to bash Islam, to bash Muslims. So we do want the United States government to hold these people accountable, whether they exist in the media or whether they exist in terms of general society, and make measures. We in fact have people within the United States government who are elected officials who have made comments against Islam and against Muslims as a whole, which has created this climate that it is fashionable and cool to bash the 1.4 billion Muslims and dehumanize them and call them anything you want, and that's considered okay. Absolutely. I mean, we had our own Prime Minister, Stephen Harper, that said the greatest threat to Canada comes from Islamization or Islamicism. He invented the word here. We strongly condemn that statement as well. We feel that generalized statements and things that are kind of saying go by association are completely wrong, and elected officials should not do it for short-term gains or for certain special interest groups that may be encouraging them to do so. We should not generalize.
When you say hold people accountable, what do you mean by that?
By that, we would mean, I mean, ideally what we'd like to do is, just like there are laws against racism, if you cannot make fun of a person's identity, there are laws against hate speech. If you find people who are deliberately trying to provoke Muslims or provoke any section of the society, there are laws on the book against inciting of violence, and I think those laws should be used, and those people should be held accountable.